Namaskar friends. Today it's the first session in this auspicious, holy, divine Dhanur month. We call it as Margari month in Tamil. As I am talking about Divya Desams, and this month is so auspicious, I don't want to miss this month. So today I'll be talking about 73rd Divya Desam. Before that, I want to give few details about Dhanur month and some details about the Pasurams. So as I'm talking about these Divya Desams, I relate it to the 4000 Divya Prabandham, because 4000 Divya Prabandham is all about the Alvars who sang Pasurams in praise of Lord Vishnu in different divine shrines. So all these divine shrines from where Alvars sang the Pasurams are called as Divya Desams. So as I've finished about 72 Divya Desams, and today is all about 73rd, I also want to tell about the divinity of this month. So we all know some basics. I mean, most of us know the details, but few like me who know very basic details, I want to give some more to it, which I'm learning now. So we know that there are two seasons. One is Uttarayanam and Dakshinayanam. So this Dakshinayanam is from the June to Jan month, and Uttarayanam is from Jan to December month. It's all about the movement of sun. Uttarayanam we call when the sun starts moving from south towards north, which is summer, and from north towards south when the sun moves, it's called Dakshinayanam, which usually is winter. So the last month of Dakshinayanam is Dhanur month, we call as Margari month. And why this is so divine is this month is dedicated for spiritual reason. Goddess Andal sows the bhakti in all the devotees by singing Pasurams. We call it as Tirupave. It consists of 30 Pasurams. So out of 4000 Pasurams, 30 Pasurams which sung by Andal is called as Tirupave. And this month we celebrate, all those who follow Sanatana Dharmam follows this month with so much divinity by singing this Pasurams in the temple early morning. I just started learning about this Pasurams, and I'm amazed with the details being sung in this each of the Pasurams. The depth of the information provided in the beautiful lines is something notable. And Andal, the way she praises the Lord, and the way the details been given in each Pasuram, when you try to understand the Pasuram, meanings of the Pasuram, it's so beautiful. And the significance is, this is written, the scripture, 4000 Divya Prabandham, all the Pasurams are sung in Tamil. So it's very high privilege, prestigious scripture for us. Today is the 6th day of Margari month. And every day is it Tirupave. They generally read one by one Pasurams every day. So 5 Pasurams were done. And today being the 6th day, I will give the details about the 6th Pasuram. Of course, there are a lot of great acharyas who gives beautiful details about these Pasurams. So I learned from them, seeing the different, with this latest technology, we have provisions to watch from different sources, correct? So from there, I learned about the meanings of the Pasurams. I may not be able to convey the complete details because it has so much in-depth details in it. But whichever that I was able to understand, I'd like to pass on that. And definitely you will have access for those details given by Acharyas, which I want you all to listen to that or read to that, so that we can enjoy the beauty of our scriptures. So the first five pasrams is all about the introductory pasrams of Tirupavai sung by Goddess Anda. Okay, who is Goddess Anda? She is daughter of Nammalvar. She was nurtured by him in Srivalliputtur. And she was grown by listening to the Ramayanam, Bhagavatam, Mahabharatam, Vishnu Puranam, like that. And as she grows listening to all this every day, she started loving Krishna, and she takes up the vow, we call as Viratam in Tamil, and in order to attain him. And she attained Lord Krishna as his wife. That's the significance of Anda. And she sung 30 pasrams. And the first five is all about the introductory pasrams about Tirupavai. Here she explains, she praises the Supreme. She explains the do's and don'ts of the Viratam vow. And also she sings and she wakes up, she invites all her friends, she wakes her friends to take up this vow, Viratam. So that's the beauty, and how she praises the Supreme is the something we have to listen and observe. Pasram 6 is about Andal requesting her friends to join the vow. Considering the nature of the friend, because everyone has their own characteristics, no? Nature of the friend, Andal sings the pasrams. She changes the content, tone of the pasrams, everything. So here she wakes her friends saying, have you not heard the sound of chirping sound of the birds? Have you not heard the sound of the conch blown from the temple? And when we see, we can imagine this. You can just imagine the chirping sound of the birds from the temple and then the conch sound from the temple. Likewise, have you not? And she asked her friends to wake up slowly. The reason is, and I love the way this has been explained by the Acharyas, because it explains how the God resides in everyone's heart. Goddess Andal asks her friend to wake up slowly so that the God, who the great Supreme Lord Vishnu, who resides in everyone's heart, he also resides in her friend's heart, should not get disturbed by if she wakes up in a hurried manner. So she asked her to wake up slowly. So that's the depth of the details sung in the pasrams. And each word has a numerous meaning, depth meaning into it. And so that is one. And also about the birds, she says Garuda, like the leader of all the birds. So Garuda is leader of all the birds. And who is the leader of Garuda? The great Lord Vishnu. So when we see the chirping sound from the temple, we know the temples, we can see the four corners, the Garudas, correct? And in front of the main sanctum also, we can see the Garuda. So relating it as the bird's chirping sound, the bird is nothing but the Garuda. And the conch sound is nothing but the conch is being held by the great Supreme God Vishnu. So these are the details I observe. And her friend asks, okay, why are you waking me up? Why are you asking me to wake up slowly? Why should I wake up and come with you? And she says, wake up, let's visit the temple after taking bath. and let us praise the Lord so that He will cool everyone's heart. First, she talks about God resides in everyone's heart. So we have to wake up slowly. Second thing, we are going to temple to praise the Lord so that He cools everyone's heart, which means He takes care of everyone without any tension and pain or stress or any health issues. It includes everything. The other thing I observed in Pastram 3 is the prosperity of the country, the benefits that we get by taking this vow has been explained in Pastram 3. Every pastram has beautiful meaning. So singing these pastrams without knowing the meaning may not give the benefits. So when we start understanding the meaning of each pastrams, I think we get goosebumps really. And thanks to the acharyas who explains all this details in great depth. So now let's see the details about the Divya Desam 73. So the intention is to talk about the Divya Desams only. I touched upon the pastrams because as I'm talking during this Dhanur month, and this month is so famous for the pastrams, I want to give the little details which I learned. So Divya Desam number 73, it's called Thiruvallan Vilai. Thiruvallan Vilai. This Thiruvallan Vilai is located in Kerala and it's very famous for boat competition. I'll come to that. The Thirukoralappan. Thirukoralappan is the Perumal's name. Parthasarthi Perumal. Here he gives blessings as Parthasarthi Perumal in standing posture, facing towards east. Padmashini Nachiyar is a concert's name. Veda Vyasa Sarasa or Pamba Teertham. As I said, there are a lot of temples besides the bank of Pamba River. So Vamana Vimanam. The significance of this temple is Lord Brahma, Veda Vyasa, Bharatvaja, Valmiki, everyone had sung pastrams or sung songs in praise of Lord from this place. So Alvar, Namalvar was a little hesitant to sing the pastrams from this place. But Lord Narayana knows the devotion that Alvar has and he calls upon him, near to him, and he started listening to the pastrams sung by Namalvar along with his concert Padmashini Nachiyar. And he appreciates the devotion and the beauty of the pastrams to his concert Padmashini. So that's the significance here which Namalvar gets. Despite the great legends like Brahma, Veda Vyasar, Valmiki, Bharadwaja, everyone sung praise of Narayana, but Lord gives special attention to Namalva's praises. So that's the coordination between Alvars and the great Lord. Let's see the details. The three temples which I talked earlier to this, that is number 70, 71 and 72 Divya Desams, were built by the brothers of Pandavas like Sahadevan, Dharmaputran and Bhimasenan, I said. Today this temple at Thiruvallan Vilai, this was built by Arjuna as a payment of atonement for killing the Karna, the Mahabharata. So he did the penance and he built this temple beautiful. So the other one I'll be talking about, the one built by Nakulan, which I'll come to that in coming video sessions. And the other significance is Aalamula. I talked about boat competition, right? So Thiruvallan Vilai is a favorite spot for the Parthasarathi Perumal. There is a nearby temple called Nilakan Narayanan. So the Lord Nilakan Narayanan wants to come and reside over this place called Thiruvallan Vilai. So he takes up the boat. in mula means boat. So aala mula, aala means six. Boat made up of six woods. He travels in that boat and he reaches Thiruvalan Vilai and he never returns to this place, back to this place. So there were people who came in search for Nilakan Narayana Perumal, and that's how the boat competition started. So Perumal came by the boat, and following him was there a series of boats that followed Narayana. So later Narayana came in everyone's dream and conveyed his interest of staying in this Thiruvalan Vilai only. So that's the significance of the temple Thiruvalan Vilai. Here he shows the characteristics of happiness. He is so happy in listening to the pastimes of Nammalvar. So he gives the characteristics of happiness here. There were shrines, Divyadesams, where I said Narayanan shows the characteristics of braveness, characteristics of courage, characteristics of complete care. He showed the characteristics of a child nature, everything. Here it is, he is in a blissful state. Here Lord shows the characteristics of blissful state. The blissful state ever than he was in, Vaikuntham. So that's the happiness that he brings in this Thiruvalan Vilai temple. So these are the details I want to share about Divyadesam number 73. Thanks for listening. We'll meet again with Divyadesam number 74. Thank you all, friends. Namaskaram.